How many types of leaves are there? Actually, two types of leaves are present. First one, simple leaves. Second one, compound leaves. What? Simple leaves and compound leaves. These are two types of leaves. What are simple leaves? What are simple leaves? Simple leaves mean leaves which have entire lamina, or leaves which have lamina with constrictions, that do not touch the midrib, are called simple leaves. Simple leaves mean leaves which have entire lamina or lamina with constriction not up to midrib. Are called simple leaves. Observe carefully. Entire lamina. Observe. This is the entire lamina. Or lamina with constriction not up to the midrib. The constriction, but not up to midrib. Like this. These are simple leaves. These are simply. For example for the simply, example for the simply fica banyan. Banyan tree, mango, okay, hibiscus, etc. Observe. Types of leaves. There are two types. First one, simple leaves. Second one, compound leaves. What are simple leaves? Simple leaves mean leaves which have entire lamina like this, or lamina with constriction, lamina with constriction not up to midrib, not up to midrib. These type of leaves are called, these type of leaves are called simple leaves. These are called usually simple leaves. Examples for simple leaves, ficus or banyan tree, mango or manjithera, hibiscus, hibiscus, China rose. Or hibiscus, rosa sinensis. Okay, observe one diagram. Next, compound leaf. Next, second type of leaf, compound leaf. Compound leaf means leaves which have lamina with constriction up to midrib. Leaves which have lamina with constriction up to midrib, with constriction up to midrib, forming small leaflets, small leaflets are called compoundly are called compoundly. Understanding? Leaves which have lamina with constriction up to midrib forming small leaflets are called compound leaves. Are called compound leaves. May for example, this is the midrib. Here lamina is, enter this lamina is constricted. For example, observe. Lamina is constricted up to midrib for forming these small, small leaflets. Like this. As they hear, these small, small leaf-like structures are called leaflets. They are called usually leaflets. This type of leaves are called compound leaves. This type of leaves are called compound leaves. Examples are the compound leaves. Neem, tamarind, neem, tamarind, acacia, prothrombus. Okay, yes, observe. Next, compound leaves are two types. Compound leaves are again two types. Compound leaves are two types. First one, pinnate leaf compound leaf. Next, second one, formally compound is. Finitely compound is and formally compound is. What are finitely compound is? Finitely compound is means infinitely compound is infinitely compound is all leaflets are originated or all leaflets are developed on a common axis. A common axis. Okay, this type of compound leaves are finitely compound leaves. Finitely compound leaves means all leaflets have common axis. For example, observe this is an axis. On this common axis, all leaflets are developed. Observe, common axis is present here. Example, name tamarind okay. Observe, finitely compound leaf. compound A. What are compound A? Compound A means which have lamina with constriction up to matrix forming a small link layer. This kind of leaves are compound A. This type of leaves are compound leaves. Okay, what? Compound leaves. Observe, why this? Lamina is constricted up to the matrix forming a small, small leaf part because of leaf shape. This type of leaf part is compound leaf. Okay, this type of leaves are called compound leaves. Observe example, neem, tamarind, acacia, rosopis, etc. Okay. Next, let us discuss about the types of compound leaves. How many types of compound leaves are present? Actually, two types of compound leaves. What are they? Pinnately compound leaves, palmately compound leaves. What? Pinnately compound leaves and palmately compound leaves. What are pinnately compound leaves? Pinnately compound leaves mean in this type of leaves. All leaflets are developed on a common axis. All leaflets are developed on a common axis. On a common axis. This is a common axis for all these leaflets. Example, neem, tamarind. Neem and tamarind. Okay, observe once again for a minute. Next, second type of compound leaves. Formedly compound leaf. Formedly compound leaf. Observe carefully. Formedly compound leaf means compound leaf which have the all leaflets. All leaflets from which have the all leaflets at a common point, at a common point that is tip of the petiole. Tip of the petiole are called pinnately formedly compound leaves. Formedly formedly compound leaf. Here actually in this type of observe, in this type of compound leaf, what will happen? Compound leaves, all leaflets are originated from a common point. All leaflets originated from a common point that is tip of the petiole. Tip of the PTO. Here axis is absent. For example, this is the PTO. This is the tip of the PTO. From this common point, like this, leaves are like this, leaves are originated. Observe Observe carefully. Here there is no any axis. From a common point, all leaflets are originated and they are grown. Like this. For example, bean. For example, bean. Okay. Yes, observe. Observe, prominently compound leaf means compound leaf which have the all leaflets at a common point, that is tip of the petiole. This type of compound leaves are called prominently compound leaf. What? Prominently compound leaf. In this type of compound leaf, all leaflets are originated from a common point. That common point is tip of the petiole. Tip of the petiole. Observe in this figure, this is the tip of the petiole. From this common point, all these leaflets originated. Okay. Next, axis is absent. Actually, in pinnately compound leaf, common axis is present. But in prominently compound leaf, axis is absent. Example, bean. Okay.